HarperCollins presents How to Catch a Dream, 21 Ways to Dream and Live Bigger and Better, by Theresa Cheung, read by Theresa Cheung. To all the big dreamers. Is all that we see or seem but a dream within a dream? Edgar Allan Poe. Introduction. Behind your eyes. You do not sleep. You believe you do because your body sleeps, but a deeply alert part of you never sleeps. While your body slumbers, you remain wide awake in the extraordinary world of your dreams. As dreams rarely make sense, you may believe they are your brain simply reprocessing and consolidating the events and lessons of your waking life. But dreams are anything but meaningless. Not only are they the key to a more fulfilling life, but you can wake up in them and gain truly life-changing insights with your eyes wide shut. If you use the 21 proven and practical nightly dreaming practices in this book, you will learn how to dream and live bigger and better. Bigger and better. You mustn't be afraid to dream a little bigger, darling. This delicious line from Ames, the character played by Tom Hardy in the science fiction movie thriller Inception, 2010, never fails to motivate me when my waking life feels diminished. Inception marked a radical turning point for me as an established dream decoding author. It wasn't just because its mesmerizing cinematic depiction of the dream world made dreaming cool. Everything about it ignited within me an intense desire to dream bigger and better myself. From then onwards, I promised myself I would fully commit to better dream recall, deeper dream decoding, and learning how to trigger the lucid dreaming state. And this book is the result of that commitment and the techniques and approaches that actually worked for me. I've experienced firsthand their benefits for personal growth and seen how effective they can be for others. Today, I'm on a mission to bring dreams, in particular lucid ones, right out of the shadows, so they are no longer dismissed as nonsense or something to be feared. I want the whole world to catch their dreams and fall in love with them, and by extension, themselves. So, what is a lucid dream? Dream recall and decoding is a potent self-help tool this book will explore, but it will also introduce you to the art of lucid dreaming, which is the most vivid and creative way to dream. Lucid dreaming happens when the parts of your brain associated with cognitive functions, memory, and self-awareness, the dorsolateral prefrontal cortex, the bilateral frontopolar prefrontal cortex, the procuneus, the inferior parietal lobules, and the supramarginal gyrus, to be precise, activate, and you know you are dreaming while you are dreaming. A lucid dream originates from a non-lucid dream. In non-lucid dreams, the self-perception areas in the prefrontal cortex of your brain aren't as switched on, so you aren't aware you're dreaming. But when they are and you become lucid, you become aware of your dream unfolding before your very eyes. You can recognize thoughts and feel emotions, and sometimes you can change what you experience, which opens up infinite creative possibilities. Common myths about lucid dreaming. There's immense value in all dreaming. Recalling and decoding the messages of non-lucid dreams is hugely rewarding. It is also the clear path to lucid dreaming, which is often considered the holy grail of dream work. But sadly, There are common myths about lucid dreaming that may be muddying the waters or making you wary of experimenting with it. It's exceedingly rare. Becoming lucid while dreaming can happen to anyone. The experience is real. Although we typically lack awareness when we dream, we all have the potential to become a remarkable exception. Lucid dreaming is more common in childhood, but is a learnable skill that anyone can develop at any age. You can get trapped in a lucid dream. Dreams can feel long, but the longest that most last in real time is around 15 to 20 minutes, so it is impossible to get stuck in a dream. For most people, managing to stay in a lucid dream is the real issue. You need to be spiritual to lucid dream. Although being mindful, imaginative, and willing to think outside the box increases the chances of lucidity, you don't need to meditate for hours, be an expert in esoteric yoga techniques, go on expensive spiritual retreats, or take herbal cocktails to lucid dream. It will cause exhaustion. Some people believe that you will wake up mentally tired or even depressed following a lucid dream because waking reality is a letdown. There is no evidence to suggest this. Lucid dreaming has a mood-boosting rather than draining impact. You wake up filled with a sense of excitement and appreciation of your hidden potential. Sleep paralysis is necessary for lucid dreaming. Sleep paralysis is when you wake up and your muscles are still asleep. It is associated with lucid dreaming and can be a precursor to it, but it isn't essential for lucid dreaming. It's scary! The first time you experience lucid dreaming, it can feel disorientating, but the most commonly reported feelings are surprise and delight. If it does feel overwhelming, you can soon learn how to enjoy the experience. If the images are alarming, this has a lot to do with your waking state of mind filtering into your dreamscape. Use the inspiration of your ability to become lucid to create a more positive waking mindset. Lucid dreaming is controlling your dreams. According to scientists, lucid dreaming is a hybrid state of consciousness with elements of both sleeping and waking. Contrary to what many people think, lucid dreaming isn't the ability to control your dreams. Thinking in terms of controlling your dreams will limit your ability to do so, as control is associated with domination. Instead, think of befriending your dreaming mind when you become lucid. In this gentle way, you can influence some of what you want to experience in your dream. Or you can choose to simply observe and let your dreaming mind surprise you. Inside out. Understanding yourself better and fulfilling your potential are what gives your life purpose and meaning. But in your waking hours, it's easy to get distracted. That's why your dreams matter. They remind you why you're breathing. They take you directly to the heart of things, what truly matters. They want you to know that your life isn't defined by the material, other people, your work, or the external world, but by your personal growth. They shine a symbolic nightlight on things you haven't given enough attention to in your waking life and reveal what you are truly feeling about yourself, others, and your life. In essence, your dreams bring new perspectives and insights and the often neglected but invaluable power of deep and meaningful reflection into your life. They are messages from your heart which need to be reflected on, but aren't, because in waking life, thoughts from the head dominate. All of us could benefit from more reflection in our lives, and that's where the real power of dream work lies. Dreams encourage us to reflect. Behind your sleeping eyes lies a whole new world of self-discovery, adventure, and inspiration. You really can use your dreams to help you deal with difficult feelings, solve problems, boost your confidence and creativity, improve your relationships, and teach yourself just about everything you need to know to live a more fulfilling life. The reason you haven't yet exploited their potential is probably because you don't believe you dream, or because your dreams never make any sense. But be assured that you do dream. Everyone does. You just aren't recalling your dreams at the moment. And the reason they don't make sense is because they come from a different state of consciousness that speaks to you in a different language. Fortunately, there are simple things you can do to boost your dream recall and decode the precious wisdom of your dreams. You'll find all these techniques outlined clearly and simply here. But more than that, what you learn will help you evolve into a super dreamer, someone who regularly becomes lucid and can use their dreams to transform their waking life. How to use this book. The format of this book lays the groundwork for a richer and more rewarding dream life. It starts with 7 practices focusing on better dream recall, moves on to 7 practices to trigger more vivid and creative dreaming, a practice dedicated to dream decoding wisdom, followed by 6 radical practices for lucid dreaming. Every one of these 21 practices can increase your chances of lucid dreaming happening spontaneously, with the final 7 most likely to induce it on a frequent basis. Within these practices, I present different techniques for you to choose from, depending on what feels good to you. You are strongly advised to take your time and learn 1 new technique each day. This shouldn't be a problem, as they are designed to fit into your routine effortlessly. At the end of each week, I provide a list of the practices and techniques so that you can tick off which 7 you would like to try that week. The first 15 practices are for repeated daily use. Don't be tempted to skip them and jump straight to the final 6 practices. You may want to lucid dream right away, but good dream recall and a mindful approach to your waking reality are absolutely essential foundations for triggering lucidity. When your dream recall is established, you can perform the final 6 practices as and when. Here's a snapshot of what lies ahead. Week 1. Dream Seeker. First things first. You can't tap into the infinite potential of your dreams if you don't recall them or enjoy recalling them. Not to mention that clear dream recall is the most crucial predictor of lucid dreaming. The 7 practices introduced here, which you are advised to repeat daily, will help you recall your dream world. Week 2. Dream Deeper. Studies show that your dream world and your waking reality are interconnected. So, the 7 practices here encourage you to live your life intuitively, with a sense of curiosity, self-awareness, and possibility that you can carry with you into your dreams. You'll also learn the optimum way to recall and record your dreams so that as week 3 begins, you can effortlessly understand the secret picture language of your dreams and become your own dream decoder. Again, these practices are ones you are advised to repeat daily. Week 3, Dream Catcher. Yes, you really can learn how to wake up in your dreams. Following the first practice, which offers basic dream decoding advice, the remaining 6 practices encourage more frequent episodes of lucid dreaming, helping you not only to awaken in your dreams, but potentially influence what happens in them. They build on the firm foundation of strong dream recall and awareness that the first 2 weeks aim to establish, and with the exception of the first dream decoding practice, are not designed for daily but infrequent use. The dreams that may come. As you work through the practices, expect more vibrant dreams to come to you at night and your waking life to feel richer as a result. You'll be on a new path to personal transformation in both your waking and your dream life. Expect your self-awareness, emotional intellect, and creativity.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.